Welcome to another episode of Show and Tell. My name is Ashley, and this is a podcast about knitting, crochet, and sometimes sewing. If you are a returning viewer, thank you for returning and clicking on this video. And if you're new, hi, hello, I am Ashley, and thank you for watching. So in the last episode, where is it? I don't even know where I put that. Here we go. Starting this episode wrong. Okay. So in the last episode, I did show you some yarn that I have finished that I made with my spindle. And you saw it and I was so proud and everything. So after that, I made something beautiful with it. I used some of my brown sheep wool yarn, which is 100% wool yarn, because this is the wool I use is wool of the Andes from Knit Picks, so it's 100% Peruvian wool, but it's a roving, and I dyed it myself, so this is blocked and everything. Look how cute! I made this cowl. Isn't it beautiful? Oh, it's beautiful. So the black yarn that you can see over here, this little strand chain right here, it is the brown sheep wool. It's all I use. Some black from brown sheep wool. The rest is my handmade yarn. I am so proud of this. It's like a project that I actually started from zero. And it was fluff, then it turned into yarn, and then I made it into a garment, and it is the most amazing feeling ever in the world, because I made everything. Obviously I did not make the pattern, but I did make the project and everything, and it's blocked, and I can't wait for winter to wear this. It's so pretty, look at it. Ooh. But it is so pretty. I decided to use the loop so I could have the chain here showing. You can see it looks really pretty. And this yarn, as I told you, it was like a bulky weight kind of, you know, it's hand spun thick and thin, and the wool was already felted a little bit. And I love it. I don't think I'm going to be making like perfect yarn, because I love this texture. I love the thick and thin and all these color things. If you ask me how I applied it, I don't even know any techniques, so don't ask me about that. I don't know what I used. I just applied it I applied it spinning the other way around. The opposite way I spun the yarn, I spun the other way to twist it together. That's what I did. Don't know any techniques. So if you're looking for somebody to show you techniques about spinning, I am not the person you are looking for. Look at Kalisha's podcast, the Quirky Monday podcast. That's the person you should be looking at, not me, because I know zero about techniques. So yeah, but I'm happy about this. So this is a free pattern I got at Joann's. It's called the Abalone Shawl. It's a cowl. So she shows it. It's pretty big and luscious and whatever on her. But the yarn she uses has alpaca, so it is a little bit more flowy. Obviously, because alpaca is more flowy, it's, you know, it's more drapey and stretchier and all that. And it is a yarn from Joann's, the one she uses. I did use a 8mm hook to make this pattern work for me. But it is so pretty, like the pattern, and works really well with the yarn I made. It was like the perfect pattern. I did have this for a rainy day, you know, special occasion. I don't know which yarn I'm gonna use, so I did it. I used it at last with this beautiful cowl I have made here. I'm so happy about it. Segue. Skip. Other pattern I finished was this pattern right here. It is Megurubi. It is by A Little Love Every Day. It was $3 on Etsy. I don't think I had a project page for this one. I should add it to project page, but yeah. I haven't taken a picture. We'll take a picture as soon as I finish recording this. It is the Amigurumi Axolot pattern. As you can see, it can fit in your hand. But I use some Karen Chunky Cupcake. I have butterfingers today. Some Karen Chunky Cupcake in the color Jelly Bean. Because I had so much of this yarn. I have a lot of cakes. Like, obviously, I don't have a lot, but it's just one cube full of cakes. But for me, that's a lot of cakes. Unless I have another cotton cake right there. So, I have plenty of cakes. I'm a cake addict. So, I need to use them in something. So, I use this cake in this project. And it is here. Isn't he cute? Look how cute. Go. It's beautiful. So I used a 5mm crochet hook to make the stitches tight. Here, see the head. It's a very well written pattern. It has very like instructions, picture details, all those for $3. Like that pattern, it's very inexpensive and it's very cute, easy to understand. Picture tutorials are like on point. I did gift this pattern to a friend. I bought mine and then I gifted another one because, you know, $3. Usually a pattern is like $6. So I was like, this is cheap enough that I can buy two and gift one to a friend because it is a good price. So yeah. I don't have a lot, but I'd like to give a little bit of what I have. And I love this little tail. I did sew the tail wrong because I did not read all the instructions. I did my own thing, you know. And then I was like, this looks ugly, but whatever. I already did it, so it's my fault. Not the designer's. It's my fault because I did not read the instructions correctly. And yes, the mouth is puffy painted on because I, as you know, I suck at painting mouths. The eyes, I believe, are 10mm eyes. I need to buy bigger size eyes like these. I get my eyes from eBay or AliExpress, just in case you want to know. Yes, things I changed, as you can see. Or if you have seen this jelly bean, or if you have it in your stash, you're like, but wait, this colorway doesn't flow like that. I know. I did my thing. I took the colors that I wanted to use, not the color that the ball intended me to use at the time. I used this is the beginning of the ball, of the cake. I used it as it went. As well as here, the yellow continued and then it went to orange, and then I used the orange, which allowed me right here to do these orange bits. But as you can see, this one right here turns into kind of a pink. Yes, that's where everything changed. I did the tail in the fuchsia pink that the ball intended me to use, and the little flippers or fins here. They're all made. Then I sewed in the tail. The legs I did not. I sewed in the tail and I was like, I kind of don't like this. I'm like, this kind of doesn't go as well as I thought it would if I used all the ball, because, you know, the colors as they flowed. And I was like, no. So I broke up the colors and I used the white to make the fin because it connects with the head you can see. And then I used some blue from another part of the ball because it connects with the top of the head. And I feel it looks more uniform. Like, if you look at it, it looks more unified. If I have put pink flippers here, can you see it? It doesn't look as well. Even though there's a little pink here, but it has little pink spots in the white. So it kind of, and in the yellow, it kind of unifies that little pink area right here. But then when I changed everything to pink, it kind of doesn't look that great. So I did my thing. I like to do that. I like to detach colors from the cakes of yarn and do my thing and use them as I please, as I want, in the order I want and need. That's what I do. So yeah, to me it looks more uniform. Like, to my eye, it's more appealing this way than if I have put the pink flippers and the pink tail and all that. I think it looks more coordinated. Does it? Or is it me? I don't know. I did put little orange blusher here, so if you see a little bit more orange here, it's a little blush that I put in. It's Jennifer's. I love him. Or her. I don't know. Probably my daughter's gonna take it away and run. So what I had left of the Karen Chunky is this. I haven't weighed it. I don't know if this is. This is blue on the outside, but it has more of that fuchsia pink. And then I have this little scrap of white. Probably will be enough to make another one because I already have the flippers and everything. So I just need to make the gills, body, and head. That's what I need to make. And because it has pink and blue, it might be, it will go very well with this little flippers and feet. Because I'm like, I can't waste this yarn. I'm going to make another one. Yes, once I finish with the other projects, because God knows I need more projects. So, next project I finish is this little guy right here. I did Eric. Hello, I'm Eric. Eric the Fox. This is my Ma de Lenon crochet designs. Madelenon crochet design. That's how you say it because it's in Spanish. Yes. So this is a pattern, if you didn't know, it's a paid for pattern. She has it on Etsy and on Ravelry as well. She has them posted and she has Spanish versions as well. Yes. And as you can see, it can fit in the palm of your hand. But I decided to make it big. So I've been trying to use my stash. So I decided to use two strands of two yarns that were in the same family color. And those two yarns were some Karen Big 1 pound, not big pound, one Karen 1 pound, kind of, I think it's coral, the color. And I don't know because I lost the ball band a long time ago. And the other one is Red Heart with Love in the color Papaya. And I made Eric. Isn't he cute? Look at his little tail. Well, his big tail. His tail is like as big as he is. Like, how big is that? So cute. There you can see him. Cover my face. So I used two strands of those yarns to make the body, the ear, and the tail. And then I didn't have enough to make the little paws because you're supposed to make them with the orange yarn as well. But I didn't have enough, so I used some Red Heart Super Saver in black, two strands together, and it is, I think it's adorable. Anyways, usually foxes have like little black paws or brown. I think it would look even cuter if I have used brown instead of black. It would have been a little bit softer. But it is adorable. And he's giant. He's a giant baby. Look at him. I just love him. And I use a 18 millimeter nose that I got from Joann's, which I need to get some noses. I just bought this one to see if I liked it and the size, but I'm gonna get some 18 and then I'm gonna get smaller sizes for other Amis because yes. Why have I been making, let's jump into other things. Why have I been making giant Amis from little small patterns? Because I want to use Stash, and then I've been watching Twitch, which is a online streaming video thing. If you watch Crochet Luna, you know what it is about because she explained it. I was going to go broadcast, but my computer is not up to that level, and my internet here, I don't have internet in my craft room, so I would have to record it in my husband's office. And there's no doors over there, so I can't keep anybody out. So for now, I will just be making podcasts and watching everybody else stream because I love watching everybody stream. So in those things, people have been making giant Pokemons. On Twitch, people have been making giant Pokemon, and I was like, oh my god, I can make, because one of them explained, oh, I just found a medium pattern of this. I think it was White Wolf. She explained that she found a medium pattern of a Pokemon and then she just made it in Bernat blanket yarn and it was giant. So I want to buy some Bernat blanket yarn and make this guy again, or even the other one, or other smaller ones. I have a frog. I might buy some blanket yarn to make a frog. I bought a new pattern. It was like $2 with a 50% off coupon because, you know, gotta save that money. But I might buy some Bernat blanket to make a really big froggy and keep him, you know, somewhere around this corner here just for you guys to see him. Or her, you know. But I went with the trend of making every Pokemon giant, but I decided to make every small amigurumi I have big. And I used for this one as well a 5 millimeter crochet hook to crochet him with two strands of yarn so the stitches were tight enough. This is Redheart Super Saver in white. And another technique I learned by watching these Twitch live streams was that you can felt acrylic yarn to your stuffies and it will not move at all. So I have a felting needle that I got from a, what is it? Daiso Japan kit, which I made that beautiful bird that you saw a few videos ago. Isn't he beautiful? He looks like he's choking on seeds or something like that, or he's half bird, half chipmunk or something. Yeah, so I have that needle, that felting needle, that came in that, and after I saw that she did the details, and then she sewed in the details, and then she felted them in, my mind was blown. I have never seen this done in any YouTube video or an Instagram or even in Amigurumi, which everybody was telling their tips and tricks and every. I didn't. I was just. I don't have any words. I just was like, oh my god, my mind is blown. And these streamers are so nice. Like you can ask them like, how are you doing that and stuff like that. They will stop what they're doing and they'll show you their techniques. And they'll show you how to start things if you're like, oh, I'm learning how to crochet. I don't know how to do a magic ring. And they'll show you their technique of making things. And it's so awesome. I feel they're so awesome because you can talk and connect and stuff like that. And I love that. So I did her trick. You know how bad I am with sewing in things. So I did her trick. I sewed in these lines right here. And then I felted them in with my felting needle. And then this loop right here, I sewed in. I sewed the loop and then I felted it in. The eyelash area is not even sewed in. I just placed the Red Heart Super Saver yarn and felted it in to the to right here, to the little eye shape. And you see the lines? Don't move at all. That is felted in. This is. It will not move anywhere. It will not go anywhere, guys. Which I saw some people on Amigurumi, they were putting nail polish on the strands of yarn so it wouldn't move. But if you're giving a toy to a kid or a baby, they're putting it in their mouth, and nail polish is toxic. So it's not a good idea. But felting it in, that's an awesome idea. It's non-toxic. Like, you're just sticking it in there so it doesn't move at all. Like, the kid can rub it and toss it, and it will not go anywhere because that is felted in. It's stuck. It's like magically glued together. That's the word I can use. Oh my god. I'm learning a lot of tricks about these makers are showing me things. They're blowing my mind, and I love it. I just love it because I learn something new every day, and I love it. Other thing I finished, just to keep on talking, I made amigurumi sushi that is in this cute little bento box. And it's for my daughter. This bento box is my daughter's Christmas gift from her aunt. And this is by Ami Amour, is in my Ravelry page of finished objects. This one is there. And I made some sushi with shrimp. Shrimp sushi and a little rice here. And then I made some sushi with salmon here in the top and rice in the bottom right here. Then I made some tokoyami, I think it is called. Takayami. Something like that. It is egg, a little strip of seaweed, and here. So I use for this one, I think it's turmeric color for in the big twist yarn. I have the colors. I'll show them all to you, and then I'll tell you the colors I use. Here's some egg with little row of fish eggs. And I have these ones. They're supposed to be tuna. Then I decided which color. This color is better for tuna than this one. It looks better. To me, it looks more like, let's just say, realistic. And then I made these little California rolls here. I might have some dog hair because she has been already using them. I couldn't help it, guys. You know, I finished something for her and she's waiting there for me to finish it. And actually, this was like my idea. I was like, oh, let's make you some sushi like right now. And then it was her bedtime and I was still making sushi. And I was like, well, I think I'll finish this tomorrow, girl, because I'm tired. I want to go to sleep too. And yeah, she was like, oh, it's my sushi. Oh, you can play with these ones. I still have to make like three more rolls. I try to make two of each. The only ones I made more were the California rolls because those ones are her preferred sushi to eat. So I was like, let's make her more of her favorite food. You know, it's her restaurant. She can serve people what she likes best. Let me tell you the yarns I used. I put it here in my little handy dandy notebook. If you watch Blue's Clues, you know. So I used Red Heart Super Saver in white, black, rouge. Okay, those no, only those ones were the white and black were Red Heart Super Saver. Loops and Threads Impeccable were rouge, cherry, and then Big Twist Baby and Dandelion, which is the yellow color. Red Heart with Love in the color Papaya, and Big Twist Premium in Persimmon. Persimmon is the orange color. that's the color. And then the green color, the green colors were like, I think Hobby Lobby, I love this yarn, and Forest Green, and the other one I have, it's probably Loops and Threads, Impeccable, and some green, because I lost the ball band. I have no clue where it is, so you forgive me, but I don't remember exactly the green colors, but those are, green colors. But I try to match as realistically as possible and not to go buy some yarn because I probably have some colors that are similar in there. But you imagine doing something at 9 p.m. and you're sleepy and all the reds look the same. So when I did the first tuna roll, I was like, I think this one is tuna. And then the next day when the sun was out, I was like, no. This is not the right red. No. So yeah, that's why one is like a bright red and one is like a dark red, which is the more natural color to use. And now let's talk about, well, yeah, I have another finished project, but it is not, it is not anything yarny. It is yarn related, but not really. So I'm gonna show you what it is. So I made this spindle. This is what it is. It's a spindle. You make yarn with it, but is it really yarny? I don't know. I made this spindle with some scrap polymer clay that I had. I used some primary colors here, as you can see, but so it has no green. It's just the blue. The blue and yellow are touching and it makes green. I thought the blue and red would mix a little bit more and make purple. But it didn't happen, so it's fine. But it does make a little bit of orange. The red and yellow make a little bit of orange there. And then it has gray glitter. So I kind of made like a block. Mixed all the colors and then I made like pieces of each and then I stuck them together and made like a block. I've been watching a lot of these things. Making blocks and stuff of polymer clay, so I was like, ooh, I can try to make my own design. It's not really a design, it doesn't have flowers or anything, but it looks kind of psychedelic and cute. I like it, it makes me happy. And then I used some polymer clay in black in the back to make it thicker because, as you can see here, it wasn't thick enough. And I did file it down a little bit. That's a good of clay, then, even if I think wood too. But wood would be more symmetrical. Clay is because you're making it yourself. It usually doesn't end up as straight as you wanted, and it wobbled. So I had to like file it down and try to make it as even as possible with the other side and in the corners here, fix the corners and file it down a little bit and make this hole a little bit bigger here. Was it a little bit? No, I think I made the right size. And then I baked it, and I used a chopstick that I had. You know when you eat sushi a lot? And they give you chopsticks and you never use them? I take them home. And I save them just for projects or some random idea I have because my brain runs 100 miles per hour. And I have random ideas all the time. So this was, I had him for almost like 6 months waiting there, and then I was like, oh, I should use the chopsticks I have in my sewing drawer. So I did. I used it. I made a little hole here, and it has no glue, but because the hole is so tight, it's perfect. Like, it fits perfectly. It's snug enough that it won't go away. Like, it won't move. And then I used a little, what do you call it? Eye pin. Yeah, it's an eye pin, and but I opened it up. It's for jewelry. I need to change it, get a little bit bigger one, because this one is too small. And I wanted to. I made this one bigger with a bigger plate. I don't know what you call it, whorl. Yeah, that's what it is, a whorl, a bigger whorl. And to ply, I made this one to ply the yarn with because it has more whorl space, and it will be enough Supply, that's what I think. Remember, I'm a newbie at this. I've been watching a lot of spinning videos, but I know no terms, no nothing, so don't judge me. I told you to go and see Kalisha because I'm no good. But that's what I mean. It's another finished project. This is just while I was practicing some things on it. And yeah. Works in progress. I am working on that wall that I showed you. I'm working on that. But I haven't touched it that much because I haven't had time to sit down in my house and really work on that. The other one is this. This is a mat that I'm making for the dog water bowl, my dog's water bowl, because they have an ugly towel and I'm tired of seeing it there, and it's ugly, hideous, disgusting, and I want it out of my living room. My kitchen slash dining room, yeah, area. So I'm making this, and then I use a gold rod color from Lily Sugar and Cream. Sugar and Cream, yeah, Lily Sugar and Cream. And this one is still made in the US, so no terrorism over here. I don't know why people are saying that, because usually everything we buy is made in China, so I'm just saying, it's ridiculous what I've been hearing around. So this is what I'm making. Tunisian crochet tends to roll. I'm using a 5.5 millimeter crochet hook here, Tunisian crochet hook. It rolls, so I'm going just to give it a little go around with some single crochet when I finish in this same coral color that I'm using from Lily Sugar and Cream. And this is a set that I showed you guys, the set that I bought from AliExpress. That I'm testing it out because I'm going to be making a review, and I have already made a few changes to it, to this hook, and I am going to tell you what I think about them, not here. So wait for that video when I finish this and give it a good run, because I like to test my things and see if they're really worth it or not for you. You know, let me spend my money and then tell you if you should spend your money. Other pattern, other thing I'm working on is in a amigurumi, custom amigurumi I'm designing. There will not be any patterns for this one because it is a drawing from my daughter, and I am trying to remake into a little Ami. So I just have the little feet here. I cut the yarn out because I was using it for something else, the black yarn for the sushi, and I needed it, and I didn't want to open my other yarn that I bought, my other black yarn, so I'm just gonna join again, the Red Heart Super Saver yarn again and make the little legs. So don't worry about that. I'll finish it soon. But yeah, I haven't finished this because I actually ran out of this pink color yarn and they stopped carrying it at Michael's. So I tried to order it online on michaels.com and they were like, nope, we're out of it, and they canceled my order. So I looked it up on Joann's. I know I know Lion Brand has the yarn, but the problem is it was going to be more expensive to buy it from Lion Brand themselves than to actually get it from one of these other retailers, because the yarn was $3.99 at lionbrand.com, and then the shipping was like $6 additionally or something like that. So it's gonna be a lot of money. It's gonna be like $12 to get just one ball of yarn. So I went to joanns.com, they had it, they had a 50% off coupon. I applied that, so the yarn was half off, and then the shipping was like $3 or something, so or $7.99, no, $3. So I paid in total $7 and something for the whole ball of yarn. So it has been, till this date, the most expensive Vanish Choice I have ever gotten. But I need to finish this project, and it's for a special person. If it was for somebody else, I'd be like, so, you know that yarn that we're trying to use? It's no longer available. Can I use something else that I can actually get in the store? Because I'm not ordering that for you. Yeah. So that's what happened. That's what I'm working on. Let me, I need to like focus again, look at the drawing and keep inspiring my brain, like keep it turning it on and focus on that to finish it because I want it to be pretty and pristine and perfect. Like I actually read a pattern for it to make it. Yeah. Sorry for the drinking sounds. Gross. So the other thing I'm working on, I'm showing you that. Let me go to my Pinterest here and show you my little project that I'm working on. This is the other project. Well, no blur. That blur, blur. I don't know what it is called. Forgive me. That's what I'm working on. This pattern right here. It is by Hooked by Katie. I have one of her other patterns. I actually bought it at a fair, which I met her in person. I have a dragon, and I have the eyes for the dragon. I just need to get my butt into it and make that dragon. So it's Regal. He's called Regal the Peacock. Right? Yeah, Regal the Peacock by Hooked by Katie. And I am using Bernat Super Value, which I love, but they don't sell anymore here in the US. So I have to get it from yourinspirations.com. Last time they had a sale and I had no money. I was so devastated. My husband's like, buy. He's like, you can buy some balls of yarn. And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, yeah. And I'm like, but I want all the colors. And he's like, oh, yeah, we don't have enough money to buy all the colors of that line. And I'm like, why? So, just feel my pain, guys. Feel my pain. Bernat Super Value in Natural. That's the color I've been using. And then I've been using, I love this yarn in Light Peach. The other colors I'm not going to show you right now because I just have the body, the beak, and the little legs. As you saw in her pattern, his beak is actually gray and he's white. But I made him cream and I made the beak with the light peach, which is kind of like the skin color. But I was looking at some pictures of real peacocks because I am just a stickler for realistic. Just make it realistic. I want to make it as realistic as possible. I don't have the colored eyes that she used, and I don't have the size that she used either. She used some 15 millimeter eyes, and these are 12 millimeters. And I had to use some eye surgery yesterday, because this eye was kind of looking like they were not. Now you can see they line up in the top. But one was like a little forward, and I was like, no, this is not happening right now. So I kind of took a pliers and like snip it all off and clipped it. It was like, what time was it? 8 p.m. when I was doing that. Don't ask me. I have problems when I do things. I do things very late. So this one is not safety. It's not a safety eye. It's just glued on because I took the safety eye out. Ripped it out of his skull. So, but now he looks so pretty. Look, when he looks at you, you can see the eyes coordinate. He doesn't look as wonky. Though he looks wonky, but it's because of that stupid fiber fill was using. I hate that fiber fill. It just made all my plushies look all wonky and weird. But I had to use it. Because I have it, I'm not just gonna chuck it in the trash and be like, I hate you. So I had to use it. Right now he looks like a little swan or something, but he'll come to life. Don't worry about it. And I made the little feet. The feet have an amazing, like, this Ami has an amazing construction. I have never worked with an Ami with this construction, and it is amazing. So you actually don't start from here. Not, you don't start from here either. No. You start from here, from the neck. It is a free pattern. You can actually buy the PDF if you want to have paper copy, but it is a free pattern on her blog. And you just take this right here and you start from here. And then you join it and then you make the head and then you make the body. It's an amazing construction, guys. And then I made the little legs. This peacock is gonna be amazing. Wait until I finish it. I have all the colors. The feathers are not gonna be green. They're gonna be cream like he is. Obviously they're gonna have that golden blue thing because even white peacocks have that golden colored thing. But they're not really white. They're kind of off-white. So I made him in this color natural. Plus I have a full ball of this when I bought it at Joann's before they took it out. So if I run out of this, hopefully I don't, I will have to go to the website of Yarn Inspirations and get another ball. Which is so sad, so tragic that I only get one of them. I should get all the colors. Why can't anybody give me that for Christmas? Let me stop complaining about that. So, yeah. These are the little legs. I love the construction. Each toe is made separately, then you leave one attached with the yarn, then you sew it on, then you crochet all of them together, and then you start reducing to make this little toe in the back, which is amazing. I was like, really? Is that really? Is this not? I'm like, what? I was really amazed. It was really amazing construction. And she has a few other free patterns. So if you really like to make amis, I recommend that you go over there and give her a little a follow on Instagram. And obviously she's not paying me. I'm not sponsoring anybody. I do it because I like her pattern. She has a cute aesthetic. She usually uses colored dyes. That's part of her aesthetic of making amis. But you can make them with black eyes. As you saw, I made mine with black eyes because that's what I had. It's a little smaller, but it's what I had. But next time, I have colored eyes for my dragon, and they're the size they're supposed to be. I will have to buy some colored eyes, really, because I'm lacking. Though I got some eyes, and they're so cute. I think I showed them to you last time. I showed them on Instagram, and they're so cute. But they were not the size I needed. So I need to buy 15 millimeter eyes, 18 millimeter noses, then smaller noses because I'm not good at sewing facial expressions and things. So other thing I finished because I was working on and I finished and I fixed it. It was already a finished object a long time ago, but I redesigned it and threw it out again at Ravelry. For you guys so you can actually understand it. Now I understand everybody's problem with it because even I was like, what the hell did I write here? Like, what was wrong with me? Why did I expect people to understand this? I know what was wrong with me. I had a 2-year-old or a 3-year-old and I was writing patterns and she was screaming all over the house doing God knows what and me stopping doing things and following her around the house. And then getting ready for work, for, you know, shower time, lunch time, this and that, and then getting ready for work. So you have to excuse that some of my patterns are not perfect, but when you have a child in your house, you can't concentrate very much. So I wrote this when she was not home, before school. Well, was she here? She was here, but she was watching TV. She's a big grown up. She was calmed down. So, yeah. I redesigned and rewrote my pattern for the simple V-stitch hat. Yes, it was the adult simple V-stitch hat or something like that. I wrote it and I changed the name. It's now the simple V-stitch hat. Because people have been asking me, you know, about things and designs and stuff like that. And some of them are not perfect. And I'm like, I have to fix that. So, yeah. You can make it as long as you want. It's a very stretchy pattern. I use Karen cupcake blanket or something like that. Big cake. Karen big cake. That's what I use. Karen big cake. And I don't know what color, but as you can see, the color changes because I had a bunch of that gray because I bought two balls for a project, and I believe after that I did not use it as intended, or I used the color I needed, and then I had bunches of yarn that I did not use. So yeah. So it's there. It's on Ravelry. It's free. So if you want to make it, go ahead, make it. If you find any mistakes, let me know so I can keep making remaking this pattern and give it an update. Keep giving it updates and be like, "Oh my God, what am I doing?" No, really. I really appreciate if you tell me, "Hey, I don't understand this, and what do you write here?" But I did count every stitch. I did do everything right. I did try to like write my grammar as best as I could, which I understood some abbreviations were wrongly written, and I was like, "What the hell did I do here?" So I fixed that. It's a free pattern, guys. I don't have a tech editor, or nor am I going to pay a tech editor because I don't have the money or the means to make that happen. And it is free. I don't have a blog with ads and stuff that they're gonna give me cash back or something like that. So I try to make it as readable and understandable as possible for me. So yeah. Anyways, what other? I have other things. Let me see. So I fixed these needles. This is a project. I bought these were the first needles I learned how to knit with. They are from eBay. They are these cheap bamboo needles. I got 12 sizes for $3 or something like that. But they have this tubing for cables that are horrible. So I decided I had this project for a little bit and I was like, I need to fix these. So I have a set for Knit Picks, and I decided to fix the sizes that Knit Pick actually doesn't sell to me because they actually don't sell bigger sizes for their hat needles, which is ridiculous because people like to make love to make chunky hats and they don't have bigger needles for that. So I decided to fix the 6.5 because the set comes until size 6 millimeter until the size 10 or 12 or 11. Let me see. I have another size over here. Yeah, until 10. From 6.5 millimeter to 10 millimeter, I fixed. I used some weed whacker cord. I used a. What is it? It's not a saw. It's a drill. A drill. A little hand drill that my husband has. It is used to file nails or metal or stuff like that. But it has an attachment for. It has a drill attachment, so I use that. But you can actually use a drill, a regular drill with a smaller bit. A smaller drill bit, but you have to tape it so you don't go too deep in the needle and make sure it's the same size as your weed whacker cord. I picked this one, which is pretty thick. It cost me like $3 at Home Depot, not Hobby Lobby, Home Depot, which is my other favorite crafting store. Home Depot, and I bought the glue at Home Depot as well, which is a special glue for plastic because this plastic is different. I did file the plastic a little bit to make it a little bit grippier, and then I put the special coating that super glue has, and then I waited the time it told me, and then I glued it in, and then I used a nail file to file the edges of the needle down here so it wouldn't catch, and it has worked pretty well. It slips and slides really well in the weed whacker cord, which is a blessing because before I had to struggle so much to use these needles, and the bamboo is really nice. So it was a it, you know, I didn't want to throw away these needles. They have some sort of sentimental value, plus they're usable. So yeah, I fixed them and they are amazing. They work really well. Right now they're like this because I haven't used them to actually make anything. But soon I will have to be making all the hats in the world and all that, you know. Winter is coming, so I have to do all these things. This is all I have to say today, and hope to see you next month if you are still here with me. And I'm sorry if I'm all over the place. I usually am, so I think you're used to it by now. And yeah, that's all I have to say for today. I'll see you next month. And as always, remember to do what you love. Bye!